Good morning, students. Today we are here to start our exercise 2.1 with question number 11. So for today's lecture, before starting our questions, we have to discuss some identities, basic identities. First one is sin inverse x plus cos inverse x should be equals to pi by 2. Should be equals to pi by 2. One is tangent inverse x plus cot inverse x should be equals to pi by 2. Similarly, secant inverse x plus cosecant inverse x is equals to pi by 2. In these identities, you have to notice one thing. The angle should be, or this value should be the same. If it is x, then it should only be x. Then it would be equals to pi by 2. Or you can say 90 degree. Okay? Then it should be equals to 90 degree, or you can say pi by 2. Here, one thing you always remember, like, how can we learn these identities? These identities can be learned in a way, like we know that sine 90 minus theta is cos theta, na? Now on 90 the angle would be changed, so here sine and cos. Similarly, tangent and cot should be changed or interchanged, so tangent and cot are here, and in this way secant and cosecant are here. In this way secant and cosecant are here. So now, with the use of these identities, we can solve our question. Like 11th question, tangent inverse 1 plus cos inverse minus 1 by 2 plus sin inverse minus 1 by 2. As we know, tangent inverse 1, in the previous questions we deal it in individual form, but here we know it in a combined form. Okay, in the compounded form we have got the question. So as we know, tangent inverse 1, in tangent the value of 1 at 45 degree, in tangent the value of 1 is 45 degree, so it should be equals to, that means I can write tangent inverse, can I write 1 equals to tangent pi by 4? Why is it so? Because tangent pi by 4 is equals to 1. That's why. Okay? Now, in the same way, as we have got the formula sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2. Sin inverse x plus cos inverse x equals to pi by 2. So here x and x both are same, therefore I can write here pi by 2, because sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2. Here x represents the minus 1 by 2. Okay, now tangent, and now because one more thing, tangent inverse and tangent will be nullifying each other and it should be equals to x only. So therefore, this and this cancel out. So answer would be pi by 4 only plus pi by 2. So on taking LCM, LCM would be 4 only. Here it is pi. Now 4 divided by 2 is 2, so 2 pi. So answer would be 3 pi by 4. So answer would be 3 pi by 4. Okay students, now move to the question number 12. Cos inverse 1 by 2 plus 2 sin inverse 1 by 2. As we know, In terms of cos, we got the value 1 by 2 at 60 degree. So I can write cos inverse and I can write 1 by 2 is equals to cos of 60 degree. Yani ki cos of pi by 3. Okay. And similarly, I can write 1 by 2 in terms of sine is 30 degree. So I can write sine pi by 6. Okay. Because cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2. And sine pi by 6, yani ki 30 degree is equals to 1 by 2. Therefore, cos and cos inverse are cancelling each other. Sine inverse and sine are cancelling each other. So it means pi by 3 plus 2 into pi by 6. So on solving pi by 3, 2 into 2, here it is 3, pi by 3. So now taking LCM, we will get 2 pi by 3. So now on solving this, we will get 2 pi by 3. Okay, students. Thank you, students.